Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now, let us see about 100 concepts in organic chemistry. We are seeing it as episode. This is the episode number 51. If you didn't watch previous episodes, I encourage you to go and see. Here, we solve 5 problems step by step. Stay tuned. Let us see the first question. They given the 3 different compounds. P1 is aldehyde, which is benzaldehyde. Q1 is imine, which attached with methyl on N position. And R1 is a just ester there, benzoic acid ester, which is a methylated one. They are asking the reactivity order of nucleophile. So you have to guess which one will be higher nucleophilicity and which one have lower nucleophilicity. From the 3 different compounds and the nucleophile, you might realize the question is really about structure versus reactivity. The answer is A. Let us see how. Here, the positive charge on carbon atom is important. The charge on carbon atom decided by electronegativity. Electronegativity of oxygen is higher than nitrogen. So the carbon bonded with oxygen is naturally more nucleophilic, and you have to decide based on that one. Let us look at the P1. P1 is attached with carbonyl, so it's more electronegative, so it will be the more nucleophilic. Let us look at the R. The R positive charge on carbon is reduced by mesomeric effect of oxygen there. So the positive charge is completely reduced there. So it will not be a good nucleophilic center. Due to the oxygen donation, definitely the CO in R is not nucleophilic. Then Q will come obviously middle. When compared to R, Q will be good. So the natural order will be B is greater than Q, Q is greater than R in nucleophilicity. Here the concepts you have to learn here is the more positive charge on the carbon, better the order of attacking. The positive charge dictated by electronegativity and mesomeric effect on O on the ester. Let us look at the next question. They given the cyclohexane with many attachments, 2 hydroxy groups and methyl group and 1 tertiary butyl group. They ask you to find optically active form. They given the 4 different structures. The structure mostly tertiary butyl group is locked, only differ in OH and methyl. Whether the OH are cis to each other or axial and equatorial, whether methyl is cis to each other or axial or equatorial. Among the many 4 different possibilities, they ask you to find the optical activity among these. So from the structure and 4 different possible configuration, you might realize the question is really about structure versus symmetry. The answer is B. Let us see how. Here your job is to find the plane inside the molecule. You have to find the structure and imagine in the 3D form. The imagination is important. Here, the first structure has plane of symmetry along the diagonal. 3 carbons are above the plane, 3 carbons are below the plane. The mirror is exactly on the middle, which is on diagonal. If you imagine nicely, the computer screen is mirror, it's like both sides. It bisects tertiary butyl group nicely in the way reflecting both methyl groups. So it has mirror inside. Then if you look at the C structure, you might realize it also has plane of symmetry because hydroxy groups are symmetrical, methyl is symmetrical, as well as you have tertiary butyl group also symmetrical. The mirror is exactly computer screen. So the compound is definitely optically inactive. If you look at the D also, things will be same. The OH groups are in equatorial, but it reflects nicely. Even axial methyl reflects nicely. So you have plane of symmetry inside. So only the B structure don't have plane of symmetry, so it will be optically active. So the answer is clearly B there. Here the concepts you have to learn here is the compound with plane of symmetry is optically inactive, and you have to imagine the molecule in 3 dimension. Then let us look at the next question. You have to limit your attacking with tertiary pentyl chloride in presence of catalyst. They ask you to find the product. when the products are substitution occur at para or ortho, or the ortho with rearranged one, or the para with rearranged one. So the four different possibilities. So from the pentyl chloride and possible four answers, you might realize the question is really about bulky reactant versus reactivity. The answer is D. Let us see how. The starting metal, you have tertiary pentyl chloride. You are using aluminum chloride. Aluminum pull the chlorine out. You have cation formation. Then the cation is primary cation. So the Wigner Meyerheim rearrangement is possible. Since the reaction is slow because of benzene moiety, this rearrangement is possible. The primary cation converts into tertiary cation there. So the rearrangement occurs. The rearrangement is Wigner Meyerheim rearrangement. Then the rearranged cation can attack the toluene there. The toluene is the two characteristic one. It can direct to ortho or para. But para will be less steric because you have tertiary group. The para position will be appropriate because of steric reason. So the para attachment will be happened, which is the rearranged one. So the answer is clearly D there. Here the concepts you have to learn here is, during the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, if you use the primary halide, it always rearranges to the tertiary or more stabler cation. Second thing is, if you have bulky substituents, always para substitution is favorable. Then let us look at the next question. The starting metal, you have long chain bromide. You are using aqueous KOH. The bromide converts into alcohol. They are asking what is the product and its nature. Whether the product is optically active with R configuration, or optically active with S configuration, or a resuming mixture, or a meso compound. From the substitution reaction and four different facts, you might realize the question is really about mechanism versus reactants. The answer is B. Let us see how. Here, starting metal, you have halide, you are using aqueous KOH. Let us analyze the possibilities there. Here, if you think of mechanism, the intermediate is secondary there. But SN1 require tertiary, SN2 require primary. But here we have secondary there. So reaction not decided by halide, we have to look at other things. So aqueous KOH is a very strong base. Strong base always go with SN2 mechanism. It go for backside attack. It kick the bromine out and it form inversion configuration. If you look at the product, which is inversion in configuration, which is optically active, if you find the configuration will be S there. Here the concepts you have to learn here is, for secondary halides, most of the time the reactivity dictated by reaction condition. Here it is dictated by base there. Then let us look at the next question. Here they are asking acidity. They given the four different amines with protonated one. First one is pyridine protonated, second one is pyrrole protonated, second one is methyl pyridine with protonated, fourth one is piperidine there. Here they are asking order of acidity. So you have to find which one lose H plus easily. Even though you may think it as base, due to the cationic character, you might realize it can donate the H+. You can guess the acidity there. You have to find which one is higher and which one is lower. So from the four structures and possible order of acidity, you might realize the question is really about nature of nitrogen versus acidity. The answer is B. Let us see how. Here you have to find the order by conjugate base character. Whenever they ask the question of order, you have to find the extreme, which one is high, which one is very low. Because of the obvious reason, the protonated one is anti-aromatic. After losing H+, it will become aromatic. So it go from unstable to stable form. So it's a very strong base there. So it will be a very weak acid. So it will go from anti-aromatic to aromatic, meaning unstable form to stable form, so it can donate the H+ easily. So it will be the more acidic one. Then you have to compare the acidity between 1 and 3. The third one is with methyl, the first one without the methyl. The methyl is very good electron donor, so it increases the electron density on nitrogen. So the conjugate base will be the stronger one. Normally the electron donation make good base, so it is a weak acid there. So the first one obviously come after second, then third will come. Remaining one obviously come fourth. The fourth one, the electron donation will be easy because of sp3 hybridization of nitrogen. Others are sp2 hybridized one. So it will be the more basic when compared to all three. So the conjugate acid will be very weak there. Here the concepts you have to learn here is, if the system go from anti-aromatic to aromatic, then you can decide the possible values here. Here, acidity is the measuring one. The H plus leaving leads to aromatic mean the structure is more stable, the compound is more acidic. Then the hybridization. More electronegative hybridization always have low basicity or higher acidity. That's all from this episode. I hope it was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. Stay tuned for next episode.